नमस्कार, गुड इवनिंग। यू वाचिंग द स्पेशल एडिशन ऑफ द न्यूज आर एंड आई एम स्वाति जोशी। टाइम्स नाउ मेगा एक्सक्लूसिव इन द एंटीला प्रोब हैड स्पार्क्ड ऑफ अ मैसिव पॉलिटिकल फाइट एंड अ डे आफ्टर द एक्सप्लोसिव परमबीर लेटर वाज ब्रोकन एनसीपी चीफ शरद पवार केम आउट टू डिफेंड द आघाड़ी गवर्नमेंट सेइंग देयर इज नो प्रूफ ऑफ एक्सचेंज ऑफ मनी। लिसन इन।
एलिगेशंस अगेंस्ट होम मिनिस्टर व्हिच इज अ सीरियस एलिगेशन। यू सी दिस पर्टिकुलर एलिगेशन which CP has mentioned, he also says in his letter, he has briefed Honorable Chief Minister and me too, meaning Sharad Pawar. In his briefing to me and his letter which I read, there is no information about actually collection of money or actually money has been transferred or handed to CM and CM, Home Minister or his staff. The decision to reinstate in service was neither taken by CM or Home Minister. It was taken by CP himself. He made such a wild allegation. Prior to shifting him from Bombay police in 2 or 3 weeks time, he never mentioned a single thing or he never made any allegation against Home Minister. All these allegations, when action was taken against CP Bombay and he was shifted from there,
कब तक फैसला हो जाएगा देशमुख पे?
मुझे लगता है कल या परसों हम बैठेंगे, कल ही बैठेंगे,
कल डिसाइड कर देंगे।
सबसे महत्वपूर्ण जगह वाजे को दी गई, सारे महत्वपूर्ण केसेस वाजे इनको दिए गए। क्या सरकार को यह पता नहीं था? क्या मुख्यमंत्री और गृहमंत्री सोए थे? क्या उनको इसकी जानकारी नहीं थी? ये बात सही है, श्री परमवीर सिंह इनकी कमेटी ने वाजे इनको रीइंस्टेट किया, लेकिन उसके बाद पवार साहब ने यह भी कह देना चाहिए कि मुख्यमंत्री और गृहमंत्री के इंस्ट्रक्शन पर किया, उनके ही कहने पर उनको वो महत्वपूर्ण जगह दी गई और सारे केसेस जो उनके अख्तियार में नहीं भी आते, सीआईयू के अख्तियार में नहीं भी आते, वो सारे केसेस उनको दिए गए। बिना आशीर्वाद के ये चीजें नहीं हो सकती।
There's a breaking input coming in as BJP steps up attack on Pawar. Sanjay Raut has hit back at the Bharatiya Janata Party. Sanjay Raut says Modi and Amit Shah also take advice of Pawar Sahib. Does it mean that Pawar Sahib lies?
मुझे लगता है कि देश की राजनीति में शरद पवार जैसे बुजुर्ग नेता, अनुभवी नेता नहीं है, इसीलिए तो प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी भी हमेशा पवार साहब का एडवाइस लेते हैं। तो क्या पवार साहब झूठ बोलते इसलिए लेते हैं क्या?
मेघा प्रसाद एंड वजीउल्लाह जॉइनिंग अस इन द ब्रॉडकास्ट। लेट्स फर्स्ट गो अक्रॉस टू आवर सीनियर एडिटर मेघा प्रसाद। मेघा, शरद पवार इन दैट प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस डज नॉट डिनाई मीटिंग परमबीर। ही इज सेइंग दीस charges against the home minister is very very serious and also assures that an action or rather a decision will be taken by tomorrow. What does that mean?
Well, Swati, first of all, Mr. Sharad Pawar, the NCP Supremo was actually forced to take a press conference on a news break that happened here on Times Now and then had to sort of clarify his position because till today morning he had no plans to do so. Complete silence from the NCP camp. Now, since you're asking about the press conference of Sharad Pawar, Swati, I want to just point out the contradiction. His own statements that he made in that entire span of 30 minutes, the press conference, the kind of contradiction that that came out. On one hand, he said, Swati, that these allegations are grave in nature. These are serious allegations. And then he says, well, these are wild allegations being made by Paramveer. Then he says, well, I don't deny that he came and met me. He met me before he was transferred out. He agreed to that. Then he says, well, no information was shared with me about how, whether money was actually collected for the Home Minister or not. I mean, Mr. Sharad Pawar, I don't know what he was actually trying to do today. At some point, you felt as if he was trying to, you know, support the entire thing that Mr. Paramveer Singh has said. On the other hand, you felt as if he was trying to defend his position, his party's position, and try and give you a picture that nothing is wrong. The government is very stable, that the MVA government is not going to fall because of one episode. And quite condescendingly, you know, he's, the other day he said that ek API ki episode ki wajah se sarkar nahi girti hai. Anyways, that is as far as Mr. Sharad Pawar's press conference is concerned today. Mr. Sanjay Raut's statement that we just broke, you know, to say that Mr. Sharad Pawar is perhaps one of the most senior, most experienced. Nobody is doubting that, Swati. He is indeed one of the most experienced politicians that the country today has, no doubt about it. But those days are gone, Swati, when the Prime Minister and Mr. Amit Shah would go and take advice of Mr. Sharad Pawar. Those days are absolutely, totally, completely gone. And that is a fact, no matter what Sanjay Raut would have you believe. Now, here is a situation right now that we are sitting on, where a meeting, perhaps it's still on at the residence of Mr. Sharad Pawar, where you have Ajit Pawar, the Deputy Chief Minister. You also have Mr. Jayant Patil, one of the senior most members of his party and a cabinet minister there in Maharashtra. You have Ms. Supriya Sule, a member of parliament, also an extremely important person in the party, and Mr. Sharad Pawar. You had Mr. Kamal Nath come in and go, and now you have Mr. Sanjay Raut coming and go. So clearly, you have the Congress participation, you have the Sena participation, and you have the main members of the NCP sitting at Mr. Sharad Pawar's residence. Now, we want to know what's happening. They're not speaking to the media. They haven't said much. But if one were to go by the indications that Mr. Sharad Pawar has given in the press conference and the answers that he gave to very specific question, when are you going to decide on the fate of what happens to Anil Deshmukh, the sitting current Home Minister of Maharashtra? Well, he said, tomorrow we sit. By tomorrow, we will decide. Hum kal baithenge. Or decide karenge. Now, within the NCP, Swati, what we are hearing is that perhaps a decision has been made and they are trying to convince a certain Mr. Jayant Patil. We have again been told that he's very, very reluctant to take up this position, citing the kind of dirt, quote unquote, which is there in the police department right there. He doesn't want to take up the responsibility. I'm being told that, you know, there are exercises over to sort of convince him to agree to it. So whatever they decide, it looks almost certain to us, unless of course something else happens, Swati, that the Home Minister will have to go. The Home Minister of Maharashtra will have to go. His position actually is becoming untenable by the minute. It is not only Mr. Paramveer Singh who has made these allegations. It is also the letter written by the former DGP of Maharashtra, Mr. Subodh Jaiswal, who's no longer there in Maharashtra. He's out on a deputation posting right now. He wrote a letter to the Chief Minister putting in detail all that the Home Minister was allegedly indulging in. Of course, the corruption in police transfers and posting. This issue has been raised time and again by various officers in the police department. The question now, Swati, is what was the Chief Minister doing? You had the DGP complain to the Chief Minister. You had the Police Commissioner complain to the Chief Minister. What was the Chief Minister doing? What was Mr. Sharad Pawar doing? And they are in no position to deny the fact that they were briefed clearly and completely by these officers about what the Home Minister was indulging in.
Right. In fact, even now, the Chief Minister is absolutely silent. As far as that meeting is concerned, we do have Vajula joining us from outside Sharad Pawar's residence. Vajula, we're given to understand a crucial meeting between leaders of the NCP and the Congress was underway. What's the update?
Well, the status quo remains the same even after the meeting is over. It was a four-hour meeting where we saw members of almost all the MVA parties were present here. You had Praful Patel, you had Ajit Pawar, you had Jayant Patil. Everybody was here in this meeting at Sharad Pawar's house. And the outcome or the takeaway from this meeting is the same as it was after Sharad Pawar's press conference, where he said the resignation is not on the cards. Anil Deshmukh has been given a chance to explain explain himself. He has also asked for an investigation, is what they've addressed the press they've addressed the media over here and said that he's also asked for an unbiased investigation in this matter to Uddhav Thackeray. So his resignation is not on the cards as of now. So the only takeaway from here is that all the four parties met here, tried to discuss about the situation that is prevailing in Maharashtra, tried to come up with an outcome, and the only thing they've decided as of now is that they will get another officer if Julio Ribeiro is not, as Mega mentioned, that he's not going to take up the case. They will get somebody with that same integrity to look into this case and make sure an investigation is done in this matter. So the decision as of now from the Pawar House has been that
Jayant Patil in fact spoke after the meeting concluded. Let's listen in.
कि इसमें से जो मेन कल्प्रिट है, जो कितना भी बड़ा अधिकारी हो, उसके अगर इसका सुराग वहां तक पहुंचता है तो सब जगह जाने की आवश्यकता है. तो उसका अच्छा इन्वेस्टिगेशन होने की आवश्यकता है. एटीएस कर रही है, एनआईए भी कर रही है, उसको महाराष्ट्र सरकार पूरा सहयोग दे रही है और हमें पूरा विश्वास है कि इसमें जो मेन कल्प्रिट है वो जल्द से जल्द सामने आएंगे.
परमवीर सिंह ने जो खत मांगा जा रहा है, परमवीर सिंह को इस्तीफा दिया जाए, परमवीर सिंह ने जो चिट्ठी लिखी है उसके बाद
देखो, महाराष्ट्र के सरकार ने ये निश्चित किया है कि इसमें ये पूरा अच्छा तरह से इन्वेस्टिगेशन करेंगे. उसमें जो अधिकारी इन्वॉल्व है, अगर बड़े कोई अधिकारी इन्वॉल्व है तो वहां तक पहुंचने की जरूर कोशिश होगी.
और दो मिनट
पहले मेरे को
हाँ, सर।
और उनके इन्वेस्टिगेशन में अगर कुछ आया तो हमारे ये प्रयास रहेगा कि उसमें से जो मेन कल्प्रिट है उसको ढूंढ निकालेंगे. अब ये जब हमने निश्चय किया है और ये कोशिश जारी है, तब उसके बाद में किसी ने अगर कुछ खत लिखा है तो मैं कल भी ये बोल चुका हूँ, ये आफ्टर थॉट है. हमें लगता है कि इससे ये जो मीडिया का जो लक्ष्य है वो विचलित करने का भी प्रयास इसमें हो रहा है.
You're watching the News Hour Special Edition, Debate Number 1 on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
Well, let's open this up and go across to our guests. We're joined by Tuin Sinha, spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party. Author Karan Verma also joins us. Chandrasekhar Jha, leader of the Shiv Sena, is with us on the panel. MC Abbas, political analyst, Ashutosh Mishra, senior journalist, and Megha continues to be with us. Good evening to all of you. I first want to go across to Chandrasekhar Jha. Chandrasekhar Jha ji, standard response to aa raha hai ki in-depth inquiry honi chahiye, jo culprits hai unko saza honi chahiye. Lekin Paramveer Singh ne apne letter mein jo sansani khez aarop lagaye, us par kahiye koi baat?
फर्स्ट सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि जो लेटर लिखा गया है वो अंडर इन्वेस्टिगेशन है. ये एकदम क्लियर बात है कि ये उनके पर्सनल मेल आईडी से नहीं आया है, जो रजिस्टर्ड मेल आईडी थी. ये देखने की बात है, ये भी पर्पस है इस इन्वेस्टिगेशन का कि वेदर दैट वाज अ फ्रेम्ड ईमेल और नॉट. तो ये अगर क्लियर नहीं जब तक होता है तब तक कोई एक्शन या उसका रिएक्शन देना पॉसिबल नहीं होगा.
हमने उनसे बात की फोन पर, उन्होंने एक्सेप्ट किया है कि उनकी मेल आईडी से गया है ये लेटर.
जी,
वी कैन प्ले आउट दैट कॉन्वर्जेशन फॉर यू. वी कैन प्ले आउट दैट कॉन्वर्जेशन. सुनिए वो कॉन्वर्जेशन.
सबसे बड़ी बात यहाँ पे है,
चंद्रशेखर झा जी, जिसमें वो कंफर्म कर रहे हैं टाइम्स नाउ को कि ये उन्हीं के ईमेल आईडी से भेजा गया है. पहले सुन लेते हैं.
Next plan would be
whatever I have to say, I brought it to notice the government. That's what I
said. So you said in that letter that you had spoken to Uddhav Thackeray and Sharad Pawar regarding this.
I'll go for the comments to make, Kajal. No further comments.
Sir, it's a very important this thing, so would like to know.
Thank
if
you.
Okay, sir. Okay.
I can only confirm that email ID is mine only.
Okay, sir. Hello?
Yeah, Kajal.
Hi, sir.
Jee,
sir, just wanted
Chandrasekhar Jha, I hope you heard that email ID is mine only. So there's no doubt that it was sent through his email ID. Paramveer Singh on record to Times Now has confirmed that.
But my answer to this is why he was kept silent or why he was silent for a period of last 1 year. If he was having all these issues, why he did not report it to the superiors or why he did not report it to the कंसर्न महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट
चंद्रशेखर जी टेल मी समथिंग डिड द चीफ मिनिस्टर एक्ट व्हेन डिड द चीफ मिनिस्टर एक्ट व्हेन व्हेन सुबोध जयसवाल मेड अ सिमिलर कंप्लेंट टू द चीफ मिनिस्टर एंड परमवीर सिंह इज नॉट द फर्स्ट पुलिस ऑफिसर टू लेवल दीस चार्जेस ऑफ करप्शन अगेंस्ट द अगाड़ी गवर्नमेंट.
No. This is particularly a frame which has been made out to the mass that the question of scam or question of corruption has erupted in this government. But actually, for last 1.5 years, this government is running very smoothly. The question has been time and again only raised by Mr. Fadnavis and the BJP.
Okay, Megha has a counter to that. Megha, my colleague, wants to come in.
Sushant Singh Rajput and
Chandrasekhar ji. Chandrasekhar ji, listen to what Megha has to say.
Yes.
So, Swati, when he says that, you know, why is he leveling these allegations now, the timing of the letter, which is suspect, he was shunted out, that's why he did it. But I think, you know, the answer was given by Mr. Sharad Pawar, no less than Mr. Sharad Pawar today itself. He has tweeted this out. He said it in his press conference, Swati. He's made it absolutely clear that I do agree that Parambir Singh came and met me. He said that. I do agree he came and met me before he was transferred out. But he says, well, the information about money actually being collected for the Home Minister, the behest of the Home Minister, was not shared with me. So, you know, what he's consequently doing, Swati, is obviously agreeing to the fact that Parambir Singh had come and met me, which he says, and had informed me, apprised me of what was happening. And Parambir Singh in that letter has written that on a certain day, I went to Warsha. He's told the Chief Minister that, sir, I came to you and I told you what was going on. I told you what the Home Minister was in. So this question doesn't stand any ground anymore. That why is he writing it now? He already was telling his superiors that look here, what is happening now? It is for the Chief Minister and Mr. Sharad Pawar to respond and tell us and clarify their position as to what they were doing about this.
Ashutosh Mishra, respond to that.
The answer to this is very simple. These people who suddenly grow conscience, the question arises here is, are those part of the rogue officers that Rahul Gandhi spoke of, who work in opposition to ruled state just to run down non-BJP government.
So if they highlight a corruption case, then they become rogue officers.
Going and meeting Mr. Sharad Pawar and going and meeting the Chief Minister and just making some allegations after that, do not in court of law stand any ground. If he had proof, I am sure he is a police officer. He knows how to go about it. Now, the more pertinent question here
is the purpose of investigation.
Why is Sharad Pawar saying that these are very serious charges?
I mean, do they have a face
why
to hide?
Why is Sharad Pawar also saying that these are very serious charges and a decision on whether Anil Deshmukh should continue as the Home Minister or not will be taken by tomorrow?
Because that is something that any fair-minded person would say.
But
that
you just said these are rogue officers.
The same allegations stand against the officers concerned also.
No, if these are rogue, if these are rogue officers, Karan Verma, why should the Agadi government even be bothered?
He could just be a part. Swati, just
why should the Agadi government even be bothered?
He could be a part of NIA.
Swati, today.
He could be a part of an NIA investigation.
No.
He's just trying to save his own.
Swati, can I come in here?
Yes, Karan Verma.
Swati, it is a very sad day today.
Okay, one by one. Karan Verma first.
For every citizen.
But there is no investigation at all.
Swati, this is a very sad day today for every citizen of Mumbai, of the country, that a sitting police officer writes to its, you know, the head of the department, the minister, and says that, you know, this is what is happening and the CM is in the loop for it. It's a sad day for the state today. And coming out here and brazenly defending it and saying for the last 1.5 years it's running smoothly, I think it befuddles logic. This Mahavikas Agadi, so-called Mahavikas Agadi, is the single disastrous political experiment of the last decade. Nothing has been stable in it. I mean, they have totally lost the faith of the people, whether it was the Sushant case, whether it was the Palghar case, and now this. Do you expect a citizen to trust the police, to trust the agencies.
All right, you know, one by one, MC Abbas, if we go by Mr. Ashutosh Mishra's logic, if Parambir Singh was working with the opposition against the government, if he's part of that lobby of rogue officers, why was he continuing as a top cop of Mumbai?
I think the anchor has asked me a question. Unfortunately, due to certain gentlemen who are speaking over each other, I was not able to hear the question. Could you please repeat, ma'am? And kindly be civil, gentlemen. Allow me to make my point. Could I hear the question again, please?
Go ahead. MC Abbas, my question is, if you go by Ashutosh Mishra's logic, then Parambir Singh was working with the opposition against the government, part of some lobby of rogue officers. Then why was he allowed to continue as the top cop in Mumbai, enjoying the confidence of the government?
Certainly, Anchor Ma'am, aapne bahut hi sahi sawal pucha hai. That is an absolute right question which you've asked, and I certainly abide by it. Why was he allowed to continue? As a matter of fact, let us also let's address the elephant in the room. Sachin Baghe being instated not by the Chief Minister, not by the Home Minister, but Parambir Singh himself. Also, as a matter of fact, Ashutosh ji is absolutely right when he quotes Rahul Gandhi, who mentioned about certain rogue police officers in the non-BJP government which are trying to befuddle the fame. Also, as a matter of fact, Mahavikas Agadi is a sore is absolutely sore eye to the BJP government, because unfortunately Devendra Fadnavis, time and again, he's turned out to be a sore loser. Therefore, he wishes to do anything and everything it takes.
You know, this is getting political. Let's talk about facts. Tuhin Sinha, is it possible?
Is
it possible for the CP to go ahead and reinstate Sachin Baze, against whom there were such serious allegations? He was suspended from the service, and then he goes on to join the Shiv Sena. Can it happen without an approval coming in right from the top?
बात है, मुझे भी अपनी बात कह देनी चाहिए।
हाँ, तो इनसे ना गो आए।
Gentlemen, when the question is addressed to me, kindly let it be. Do not talk over each other.
Okay, one second. Nobody was talking when you were answering, sir. I have just asked a question to Tuhin Sinha. Let him respond.
Parambir Singh's letter came out, and it is absolutely shocking that in these 28 hours, neither has the main accused Anil Deshmukh been sacked, nor has there been a single statement from Uddhav Thackeray, which only confirms that apart from this being the murkiest state government in India right now, it is also the most thick-skinned and the most shameless state government. Now, three quick points. देखिए, अगर ये वाकई 100 करोड़ का मामला है, तो ये राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा का मामला बन जाता है. अगर 100 करोड़ जुटाए जा रहे थे, तो किस कारण से जुटाए जा रहे थे?
ओके, मिस्टर झा, आई गिव यू अ चांस टू काउंटर दैट. लिसन टू हिम फर्स्ट.
अंबानी जी के घर के बाहर
सुनिए उनको. आई गिव यू अ चांस टू काउंटर.
बीच में मत बोला करिए, थोड़ा सा पेशेंस रखिए. आपके बीच में मैं नहीं बोल रहा था. दूसरी बात, शरद पवार ये आरोप लगाते हैं कि परमबीर सचिन वाजे की अपॉइंटमेंट जो है पूरी तरह से परमबीर सिंह के साथ के कहने पे हुई थी. ये बिल्कुल झूठ है. परमबीर सिंह ने वो कमेटी हेड किया था, बट दैट कमेटी वाज अपॉइंटेड बाय नन अदर देन चीफ मिनिस्टर. तीसरी बात, उद्धव ठाकरे पे दोबारा मैं आता हूं. अनिल परब जो शिवसेना के मंत्री हैं, आज देवेंद्र जी ने स्पष्ट किया है कि अनिल परब वाज एक्टिंग एज अ सेकंड होम मिनिस्टर. And probably a lot of things were happening, you know, without the knowledge of Anil Deshmukh. So this entire matter is seeped in such controversy and in such deep-rooted conspiracy that eventually, you know, the National Investigation Agency might have to head towards this also if 100 crore is actually involved.
When you're saying Anil Parab was taking all the decisions at the behest of Anil Deshmukh and maybe he did not know, you're giving him a benefit of doubt. I want to take a very short break on the broadcast. Post that, we'll continue our discussion. Stay on with us.
The News Hour Special Edition. We'll be right back after this break.
Welcome back. Sharad Pawar today in his press conference said that Waze was reinstated by Parambir Singh, not by the Chief Minister or the Home Minister. But I want to ask you, Megha, is it possible for a CP, a Commissioner of Police of Mumbai, to reinstate a tainted officer and then hand over serious, sensitive, high-profile cases without keeping the Home Ministry in loop?
Oh, no, not at all. Not at all. I really, really don't think, and having covered the Mumbai police for a long, long time, Swati, I don't think that this would be a situation about the commissioner completely acting on his own and not keeping his political bosses in the loop. That's not how things work there, not at all. So for the Home Minister, I think, you know, it all started after Mr. Parambir Singh was very unceremoniously shunted out. And then within 24 hours, you had the Home Minister trying really hard to distance himself by suggesting at an event that there were quote-unquote unforgivable mistakes being made by commissioner's office, and that is why he was moved out, to ensure free and fair investigation. Well, the point is that you are the person who heads the department. You are the home minister. So how is it that you are trying to wash your hands and, you know, distance yourself by saying this, by suggesting this? And this is not the end of the story. Now, when it comes to the appointment of Sachin Waze, two things, Swati. One, I think we should, you know, always remember the charge. And it's not only a charge, it's a former chief minister who's made a claim before the media. And I'm quite sure he knows what he's talking about. He says this in a press conference here at the BJP headquarters in Delhi. Just the other day, Mr. Padnavis said, he went on record to say that in 2018, I got a call from Mr. Uddhav Thackeray requesting for the reinstation of Sachin Waze. Right? Where was Mr. Parambir Singh then? Hmm. You had Mr. Uddhav Thackeray, who was asking for this for almost 3 years. Hmm. And as soon as he becomes the chief minister, well, and they cite the reason for lack of policemen during Corona, they form a committee. The committee is formed under the guidance of the chief minister. It is, while you can, you know, technically try and put the blame on Mr. Parambir Singh, but the committee was not formed by Mr. Parambir Singh. And you think a decision of this nature, where you have a suspended officer was suspended for 16 long years, right, to be reinstated in the force, a decision that would be taken only by Mr. Parambir Singh? Well, no, I don't think so at all. And one really needs to get to the bottom of this. And Swati, let us also not forget that the investigation, both by the ATS and by the NIA, in all both the cases, the murder of Mansukh Hiren and the gelatin suspected car case outside Antalya, both are on. So I think it's just too soon for anybody to sort of come to a conclusion as to what was happening.
Absolutely. In fact, Chandrasekhar Jha, right after the Home Minister of Maharashtra said there were unpardonable mistakes and so an action was taken, just a day after that, your party says Parambir Singh was being targeted by the centre. If he was being targeted by the centre, why did your chief minister, as per Sharad Pawar, because the chief minister takes such decisions, why was he shunted? Why did the chief minister decide to do so?
See, the first reason is when a police officer is getting somewhere involved into controversy or into some kind of illegal acts, the government has to first suspend him and thereafter carry on the investigation, show cause him, and then proceed for the trial. First thing. Second thing, the government has rightly acted, since there is some kind of proof or some kind of allegation involving Parambir Singh with the Antalya case. That has been also been made by Mr. Anil Deshmukh as well as the other dignitaries of the government. Now, the thing is that very clearly,
sir,
Mr. Parambir Singh
also, where a to minister
shred no, away no, one second, let him finish. Let him finish because he's emphasizing on some evidence. Yeah.
Suspended.
Go ahead, should finish
your point. Should also not be suspended? Same logic.
No. There might be allegations.
No, just a question.
See, first thing is that the allegation.
You are contradicting yourself. When if you're talking about evidence, you're talking about proof, then Ashutosh Mishra, what about the WhatsApp chats that Parambir Singh attached in that letter?
No.
Correct. Yes.
See, these kind of proofs are required to be proved in the trial. First thing.
So are you considering it?
It has to.
So are you considering when you're saying that it has to be investigated? Are you considering that he had those conversations with other officers and he reached a conclusion that the Home Minister was asking Sachin Waze to collect 100 crore rupees per month? In that case, you're considering it. Ashutosh Mishra wants to come in.
State security.
It is one kind of evidence. No. It is one.
No. I want Ashutosh Mishra to come in.
Which has to be investigated.
Ashutosh Mishra.
Evidence which has.
So, Swati, Neha was speaking about Padnavis' accusation that he got a call from Uddhav Thackeray in 2018. So, let's remember there is no love lost between BJP and Uddhav Thackeray. You remember what Sena said about Amit Shah making a promise in a closed room, and thereafter they have been vying for each other's blood. So, to presume that Padnavis is some Raja Harishchand who will always speak the truth, we should take it with a sack full of salt. Let us be clear on
Swati,
that.
Swati, that does not apply here.
Yeah.
Let's not blame BJP.
No, no, no,
if they are including from
Swati, you can use animal soul. That's absolutely all right. You don't believe him. You don't believe him. Don't take his statement on face value. But can you please explain to me, sir, the urgency with which they have got, I mean, which government? Can you, you know, I'm going to put everything in perspective, sir. Tell me, three successive governments, which included NCP holding the home ministry, they did not get Waze back. Mr. Fadnavis did not get Waze back. And in fact, he admits to the fact that I took legal opinion yes. of the AG and asked him if he could be reinstated. And I was, advised against it. So I decided against it. All of that, three governments decided not to get him back. And here comes Uddhav Thackeray and bang, the first thing you know is that this, you know, a few handful of officers who are picked up to be brought back into the force.
Why, Ashutosh Mishra? Respond to that. No, Ashutosh Mishra, then I want to go across to MC Abbas, Karan Verma and Tuhin Sin as well.
So, 2 points. First of all, what I am questioning is, you know, Swati, whether what Fadnavis is saying about the
Maharashtra today.
Number two, the IPS officer in Bombay has obviously learned from the episode in Delhi where two IPS officers fought amongst themselves. And the IPS officer who was on the right side of Amit Shah and Narendra Modi, that is the BJP, was saved while the other IPS officer was hanged. So now we are talking about the NIA investigation reaching the top.
Karan Verma, Chandrasekhar Jha said, when there are allegations against a senior police officer, that senior police officer has been suspended. That senior police officer has been suspended, and that senior police officer is now leveling charges against the Home Minister. Shouldn't an action be taken against the Home Minister as well?
Absolutely. I think he should resign with immediate effect. I mean, it's a shame today that Maharashtra as a state has to go through this. He should resign on moral grounds, and if he doesn't resign, he should be fired immediately. I mean, I am aghast at what is happening today that Mr. Anil Deshmukh is allowed to continue. A sitting home minister, and a home minister is the single most critical minister after the chief minister, Swati. And if that person is, you know, facing allegations of extortion, it doesn't augur well for the state. It doesn't augur well for the government.
Absolutely. Especially after the party chief himself says that these are very, very serious charges. One would expect them to take action.
Swati, one more point. Today is not the day. Today is not the day when we talk of BJP or Devendra Fadnavis or Modi or Amit Shah. Today, this Mahavikas Agadi, which has brought so much of disrepute to the state of Maharashtra, they are including from within.
Okay.
The onus is on them.
The onus is on the Mahavikas Agadi to explain why Parambir Singh is leveling these serious charges against the Home Minister and what action are they going to take. Although the Chief Minister still has not spoken about this controversy. I'm taking a very short break. After the break, we'll continue our discussion. Stay on with us.
The News Hour Special Edition. We'll be right back after this break.
Welcome back. All our guests continue to be with us. Tuhin Sin, I want to come to you. Sharad Pawar today said, "Aise case se sarkar par koi farak nahi padta. There will be no impact on the government." On the other hand, some in the Mahavikas Agadi are also claiming that the BJP is only trying to destabilize this government. How do you respond to those charges?
You know, the Sharad Pawar's press conference today was the most disappointing press conference ever by a senior leader in the country, where the entire objective of that press conference was to obfuscate and to confuse issues. Now, I'm telling you, Anil Deshmukh has been such a terrible disappointment as a home minister. Everybody knows that he alone cannot, the 100 crore thing cannot be his brainchild. And that is where the onus and the buck stops at the chief minister's office. That is where the buck also stops with Sharad Pawar, who has been named by Parambir Singh as one of the persons who was privy to the information, because apparently Parambir Singh has shared the information. And that is why the entire, you know, the sheer shamelessness with which the two sides want to defend each other is absolutely appalling. I only feel sorry for the Congress, which might be left out of the exercise at this point of time, but the silence of the Congress only gives you the impression that Congress perhaps is also, you know, probably bargaining for its share of the exploits.
You know, MC Abbas, so much has happened in this case. The controversy now reaching the doorsteps of the chief minister, and not a word from him.
Rightfully, Swati ji, it is high time that Mr. Uddhav Thackeray needs to come to the fore and take the bullets, take the questions accordingly. I think we need to look at the perspective of which Megaji has applied here. Is Parambir Singh, does he have the competent authority or the power to appoint or reinstate a Sachin Waze? There needs to be a certain probe there. But now coming to the front that I think BJP, the Bharatiya Janata Party, especially Mr. Devendra Fadnavis, has this habit of counting the chickens before they hatch. Let there be a probe. Shun Parambir Singh into the jail for his misdeeds or even Sachin Waze. But can this shake the Mahavikas Agadi? Not an inch, sir. Not an inch.
It's not and about shaking the Mahavikas Agadi. It's about knowing the fact.
We don't need to shake.
It's about investigating the allegations leveled by Parambir Singh. Also,
go to the gutter.
It's, you know, also what I want to understand from Megha is this conspicuous silence because there was always a tussle over the Home Minister's post?
Well, Swati, yes, you have actually pointed, hit the nail on its head. There was a problem. There has been a problem right from the very beginning. Let me tell you this, that at the time of this government formation a year and a half back, there was a problem because, Uddhav Thackeray, who was becoming the chief minister for the first time, also did demand that he be allowed to keep the Home Minister's position. Now, there were too many discussions that had happened back then that if you have to keep the Home Minister's position, then the Chief Minister should not be there with you. All sorts of things happened. The bargain happened. Home Ministry was a sticking point between the NCP and the Shiv Sena. Both wanted it and the NCP was not ready to give it up at any cost. And now, when there is a problem currently, let me tell you this, that one casualty from the side of Sena, Sanjay Rathod, happened. And now, insiders are telling me that the Shiv Sena is seeing this as an opportunity to get back at the NCP, saying one casualty from our side. And here we've been having a problem with your Home Minister for quite some time. This Home Minister has not gotten into trouble just now. There have been allegations against him. He has, perhaps there have been complaints against him. And I'm not talking about the complaints that Mr. Parambir Singh has made or the former DGP has made. There have been too many things going on within the government there in Mumbai, which has reached the Chief Minister's door, which has reached Mr. Sharad Pawar's ears, and yet nothing was done. So they are now saying this, that all the alliance partners together, which is apart from the NCP, you have the Congress and the Shiv Sena, both of them are of the opinion that this Home Minister needs to go. So this Home Minister, you make him resign, and then perhaps then it's again up for bargain who gets it. Shiv Sena may want to ask for it again. We don't know what's going on, but right now it looks to us that there is pressure building on the NCP from the side of the Shiv Sena quite clearly, and of course Congress also chipping in to suggest that it
absolutely
is time.
One would say that they're demanding the resignation now of Home Minister to save themselves. Also, Mr. Chandrasekhar Jha, if going by this rate, if the Chief Minister continues to be tight-lipped and not answer these serious allegations, I think you'll end up destabilizing your own government. You wouldn't need a BJP or anyone else to act as a catalyst. On that note, I'm wrapping up the debate. Thank you very much, Megha, and all the gentlemen for joining us on the debate.
The News Hour Special Edition will be right back after this break.